In this video, I will be talking about what dog anxiety is so that you know whether or not your dog actually is an anxious dog. If you're interested in finding out the answer, keep watching. Jenna with Dog Liaison, where I coach you on how to enhance your dog's mental health. I'm a professional dog trainer at Dog Liaison. All we do is work with dogs facing behavioral issues. So aggression, reactivity, separation anxiety, stereotypies, and other behavioral complications. Most of those behavioral problems stem from anxiety. And so I have dedicated my life to understanding what anxiety is in dogs and how we can best identify it. And so in this video, I kind of want to clear up some of the vagueness of what anxious actually looks like so that you can better know how to support your dog. First, let's define what anxiety actually is. Anxiety is a heightened state of fear or stress. Think of it like fear on steroids. Fear is a very normal experience for all species. All species experience fear. And fear isn't necessarily unusual or bad when it comes to dogs. It's not something that we need to necessarily be trying to avoid all fear in our dog's life. That might be a little unrealistic. But fear is, generally speaking, proportionate to whatever the trigger event is. The response that we get out of a quote-unquote normal dog, and bear with me on that because I know that's sensitive, but on a quote-unquote normal dog would experience fear would be proportionate to whatever the event is. In anxious dogs, however, their fear is exacerbated and it is disproportionate to what the event actually calls for. Their fear is heightened. Their experience is more stressful. It is an extreme case. But on top of that, anxiety is also the preparation for fear. So this is when a dog is aware that there is about to be some sort of fearful unknown event occurring, and the dog's body is preparing it for this event. So the best way that I can explain fear and anxiety is that if fear is the immediate response where the trigger is there and we are like, we're experiencing fear, we are in it, here we go. Anxiety is the preparation for the fear. It is the buildup. It is the, oh my gosh, what's going to happen? Oh my gosh, we're getting ready for it. Oh, I can feel it. And so anxiety tends to be a little bit preemptive to the real event. And that kind of leads me into one of the first signs that your dog is actually anxious, which is that, do you notice your dog starts becoming stressed or queasy before they go for this, say, event? So for example, if your dog gets very fearful and sensitive on walks or overwhelmed on walks, are you noticing that your dog demonstrates anxiety as soon as you start getting ready for the walk around the house, like you're putting on a certain pair of shoes or you're grabbing the leash? Is your dog already starting to demonstrate anxiety? Another example would be if it's a noise phobia. When they're at home, are they constantly waiting for a noise to scare them and they can't necessarily sleep because they're always restless and waiting for an event to occur? That sort of restlessness is anxiety. Now, anxiety has a lot of different forms. There are a lot of different anxiety disorders in dogs. So the common one that we would all kind of refer to would be separation anxiety. But separation anxiety is sort of an umbrella term for a lot of different separation-related problems. So separation anxiety would just be kind of like one facet. It's like one little cornerstone of the anxious dog world, right? But then you also have other phobias. So there are noise sensitivities, there are phobias of different stimuli. Your dog may be experiencing a different phobia or panic disorder that would still be considered anxiety. Here's what I like to tell people is that most of the dogs that are experiencing anxiety and the owners are aware of that anxiety, most of them are dealing with a more generalized anxiety disorder. And here's why I say that, because this is just an opinion, okay? This is just based off of my experience. The people that would call their dogs anxious, the people that would say, I think my dog has anxiety, usually see anxiety chronically. They're seeing it occur day to day in the dog's life on a recurring event, and it almost feels like the dog is never really calm. The dog is always restless. He's always uptight. He's always spazzing. He's always highly aroused. And so in my experience, the people who call their dogs anxious are the people who are seeing that their dogs are always on. But that doesn't necessarily mean that no other dogs are anxious. A dog can have a noise phobia and still be having that anxiety disorder, but owners, their guardians, are not necessarily calling it anxiety. They're probably just calling it fear, or they're probably just calling it sensitivity. So I think this is one of the reasons why for common dog guardians, it can get a little confusing, because when we think of anxiety, we think of it as like just the extreme. We think of it as just like the dog is always spazzing and the dog is on some next level crazy. But it doesn't have to be that extreme. It doesn't have to be that serious. It can be on a more minor scale and still be anxiety. I think what I would like to kind of reframe is that when it comes to fear and anxiety and how they kind of correspond and how they work together, I want you to think of it in terms of a spectrum. It's not like a dog can be easily classified in a perfect square box and say, this is what's going on, right? Or this is what's going on. Instead, it's like if there's a line, if there's a spectrum, the dog falls somewhere on this spectrum of like, well, he's a little bit more anxious than he is fearful. Because the truth of the matter is that only a veterinarian can give a formal diagnosis, period. Not me, not some other behavior consultant, not some other dog trainer on YouTube, not a book, not your friend, not your groomer. No one else can give a formal diagnosis to your dog except for a veterinarian. When we're thinking about classifications and actually labeling a dog, I think sometimes it's easier for us because we are simplifying it. We're like giving a name to what we're seeing, and that helps our sort of human brains. But the reality is that we have to be careful with classifications because dogs don't fall under just one bubble. They don't fit under just one little label. They're multiple different things. And so that's my first warning when it comes to like anxious dogs. The other thing that I would say is that our anxious dogs are very often in need of behavioral medication. So behavioral medication, if you're not aware, I have two videos expanding on what anxiety medication is and the different types of anxiety meds. So I definitely recommend you watch those two videos. I would also recommend that after you watch those two videos, your next step would be to check out this video that I did with Dr. Pockel, who is a board certified veterinary behaviorist. And he's going to be able to expand on why a vet behaviorist may be necessary for highly anxious dogs. One of the things that I'll expand on is that when you have a dog that is experiencing chronic stress and generalized anxiety disorder, when you have a dog that is experiencing that degree of adrenaline and cortisol and struggle on a daily basis, you generally need some sort of behavior medication to support that dog through their learning. And I don't say that necessarily to like scare people, because I know there is a stigma around medication, but what I say to that is, let's be open-minded. I'm just asking you to be open-minded and to conceive the possibility that your dog would do better if they were on some sort of behavior medication that is going to help them feel better and be able to regulate their stress more. Okay, so here are some actionable steps that you can take right now to support your potentially anxious dog. Or if you don't know, you could still do these steps to find out if your dog is anxious. The first thing I recommend doing is doing very simple training methods. Doing things like every single time that you notice that your dog is calm, you go over and you give some sort of treat. Simple things like creating more routine in your day. Simple things like playing soft music or turning on a Daptil spray. By all accounts, simple things, okay? And they are minor solutions. And so a lot of times when we recommend these, people go, oh, that didn't work. Okay, maybe it didn't, but that means you're ready for the next test. Because if they didn't work, that tells you that you're probably closer to anxiety than you realize. If they worked magically, if you turned on Daptil and started rewarding calm behavior, and overnight you've got a brand new dog, and it's like, oh my God, my dog has just been rejuvenated and this is the greatest thing on the planet, I'm so happy for you. That's wonderful news. But probably your dog doesn't have anxiety, because anxiety is a little bit more serious, probably not going to be resolved by just turning on a couple pheromones and singing lullabies to your dog, implementing more routine. It's probably gonna be a little bit more involved process. So that's the first step, is to run that little experiment. The next step would be to watch the three videos that I mentioned earlier. Those are also linked in the description boxes below for you to easily reference. Those are going to help you understand what behavior medications are, the different types of behavior medications are, and how to have a conversation with your veterinarian about your dog's anxiety. So all three of those videos are going to be imperative for you to view. If you're able to schedule an appointment with a veterinary behaviorist, then more power to you. However, a veterinarian will suffice. Then, once you know whether or not your dog is a candidate for anxiety medication, then it's time to worry about having an actual behavior modification protocol. Now, you want to pick a protocol that is going to be based in compassion and understanding, not in ridicule and punishment. When you pair anxiety, which is a fear-based disorder or stress-based disorder, when you pair anxiety with punishment and ridicule, you are just doubling down on the negativity. Yes, you are implementing routines and predictability, which is helpful, but there are a lot of ways that you can implement routine and predictability without punishing your dog. You want to pick one that is backed by science. And so for more information on what that science actually says about training protocols and the best way to train dogs, I recommend you watch this video right here for more information. You need to find a coach that also understands that anxiety is a for life thing. And now if we can get real for a second, one of the conversations that I have with every single one of my clients in the RRP is that they need to accept that anxiety is a for life condition. It is not something that just goes away one day because you've given enough treats to your dog. In the same way, giving enough Oreos to an anxious child is not going to miraculously cure them of anxiety. Think about this in terms of anxiety in people. People will learn how to manage and mitigate as much as possible what is anxiety inducing. They become better at making coping skills to handle how they're feeling about a certain anxious moment. They're going to come up with strategies to work through that anxiety in that moment. But they're still going to have phases in their life where that anxiety is worse than others. And that is true for dogs. Our goal is not to eliminate all anxiety from your dog's life for the next 15 years. That might be a little unrealistic, my friend. Instead, our goal is to eliminate what does not need to be anxiety inducing. The things that are currently causing your dog anxiety, can we eliminate some of those things so that he knows that those things are actually safe and enjoyable and fun? Can we change the association of those events? That's number one. Number two, can we create a coping mechanism? Can we create several coping mechanisms, for that matter, for the dog to handle anxious moments when they occur? Do we empower the dog with the ability to tell us when they're feeling uncomfortable with a situation? That's a coping strategy. And three, we learn to recognize when our dog's stress is going through a particularly tough phase. We learn to recognize when, for one reason or another, our dog is going through a moment in his life and his year that is especially stressful for him. And what do we do while he is in that phase? That is the process of living with an anxious dog. And if your coach is not walking you through those three steps on exactly how to do that, then the coach doesn't have an understanding of what anxiety is and how to support your dog. So if you're looking for a program that is going to help you help your dog through anxiety, then I would love to welcome you to the Recovering Rover program. For more information on that, you can go to getacalmdog.com to learn more about the RRP. If you enjoyed this video, do me a favor, hit that like button, consider subscribing for more information on anxiety. Hit the notification bell if you aren't already, and I'll see you guys in the next video.